And we welcome you to Seattle, Washington on a beautiful Saturday afternoon here. Cold and crisp, but I promise you one thing, it's going to be hot in the Bank of America Arena. This one for first place in the Pac-10 Conference as Pac-10 College Hoops, presented by KFC, brings the UCLA Bruins to Seattle to play the Washington Huskies. And here's where we stand in the Pac-10. Bruins and Huskies, five up, one down. One of them walks out of here with first place in the conference. And hello again, everybody. I'm Barry Tompkins, my partner, the coach, Dan Belwamedy. And Dan, I think any win on the road is a good win. And UCLA had to withstand a Washington State comeback on Thursday night. But the bottom line is, they did it.
Well, they really did. I thought UCLA played great, especially in the second half. So it was a very intense crowd in Pullman. And how about Dragovich? Made six threes in the game. So he was outstanding. And Darren Collison was a bit quiet, Barry, most of the game until they needed him late. Then he came down the stretch, made a couple of field goals, a few free throws. Collison broke him down and really made the big plays. So Dragovich early, Collison late. It spells success for UCLA, and they come out of Pullman with a big win.
Yeah, they were up 15 in that ball game into the second half and had to withstand a great Washington State comeback. But the bottom line is, as we said, they did it. Here in Seattle, you and I were here when Washington played USC on Thursday night. USC, yes, they were a man short in Dwight Lewis, but you got to give it up for the Huskies because they not only won the game, they won the game without their big man making a basket.
Well, they did, and of course, that's John Brockman. It was really a live crowd on Thursday night. But how about Justin Dettman? Did he do a beautiful job driving to the goal? Dettman with a big night, made 11 out of 11 from the free throw line. He made three threes. Isaiah Thomas, his backcourt teammate, also allowed the game to come to him and made big scores. But how about Brock? No field goals, 13 big rebounds, and really a great job by the Huskies to pull out that win.
Yeah, and Lorenzo Romar said he's got a hungry John Brockman on his hands today. He expects he will bounce back and bounce back with a vengeance. It's a great matchup. Two teams who like to play different tempos. Bruins would like to play it in the 60s if they can. And of course, the Huskies, they prefer to play it in the high 70s or the low 80s. So who can dictate tempo is going to go a long way toward deciding who wins. Well, there's no question, but this place is going to be rocking. We're at the Bank of America Arena here in Seattle. A sellout crowd for the second game in a row for the hometown dogs. And why not? They have an opportunity with a win here today to take over first place in the conference. Here's the way the Bruins will come to the dance. Nikola Dragovich, and Dan talked about it, 6 of 7 beyond the arc on Thursday night. Alfred Aboya, he's going to have to bang bodies on the post with Brockman. Darren Collison, when they need a basket, he's the guy. Josh Shipp, he's the X factor in this game. And the talented freshman, Jeru Holiday. Four. The Huskies. It'll be Quincy Pondexter with John Brockman. No field goals the last time out. Darnell Gant gets a start. He's a rebounder and a good passer. Isaiah Thompson and Justin Dettman in the backcourt. Both can score. Both can handle the ball. Right now, let's take a chance to meet our third member of our team. Here is Carissa Thompson. Carissa.
All right, Coach, you've won 12 out of the last 13 games. What's the biggest reason for your team's success?
I think we're playing better defense, and we're sharing the basketball. We're playing together.
You're now playing for sole possession of first place in the Pac-10 against a tough UCLA team. What's the biggest thing that worries you about them?
We have to be able to score on them. They're a tremendous defensive team.
I know that turnovers were an issue last game. You'd have a discussion with your team about those?
Well, you know, we had been averaging 12 a game. In league play going into the last game. So let's just hope that was an aberration.
All right, take care of the basketball. Thanks, Coach, for the time. Good luck today.
Thank you.
All right, thanks very much, Carissa. And there is Lorenzo Romar's counterpart, Ben Holland. And, you know, to talk about what he has done at UCLA, whatever you say, it's an understatement. You can see his record. He's been to the Final Four three times in a row. Speaks for itself.
Yeah, it really does. And, of course, you know, Ben, the three-time defending UCLA Bruin Pac-10 champions. And it's already Ben's sixth year at UCLA, and you're right. And Lorenzo should be worried. This is a very, very good defensive UCLA team led by Darren Collison. And you know Collison will steal the ball, Barry. He'll get in the open court. So Washington has defeated UCLA four consecutive times. here in Seattle. Should be a terrific game this afternoon.
Well, I think it's imperative for UCLA to try to get the crowd out of the game. See if they can jump the Huskies early. They're going to try to take some time off the clock on virtually every possession. Of course, they'll take the early break if it's there. This is Collison all the way to the basket. Tried to dish, and stepping in front was Gant. And it's going to be out of bounds to the Huskies.
And you'll notice that, Barry, all afternoon. The one thing Washington did, they do a beautiful job. Their big men will establish position on all penetration and try to draw the charge.
Pondexter in the lane, blocked by Shipp. And here's Collison, 2-on-2. Collison over Thomas. Couldn't get it to go, and it's going to be out of bounds off of Aboya. Maybe a little case of nerves on both sides to start this game. Neither team really settled in quite yet. Now, Gant, they won't guard real closely. Although he shoots a follow, he comes up short. Shipp with the rebound for the Bruins.
Now, I think Ben Holland will give Gant that shot every time. I mean, this should be an unbelievable guard matchup game. I mean, there's four tremendous guards on the floor.
Yeah, quick on quick. This is Aboya working on Brockman with the left hand.
Well, you got to love that shot. Little left-handed runner in the lane. Nice play by Aboya. Solid, makes the right play. Good defender, hard worker. Intense in the middle defensively, Alfred Aboya.
Smart guy, graduated already. Thomas for three. A little bit short, he had a pretty good look. Holiday with the rebound. Quick outlet to Collison, 3-on-2 again. And Collison picks the dribble up, leaves for the trailer Dragovic. Now Collison again, Shipp behind the screen. And that's a three.
That's the one thing about UCLA. Now Shipp, you know, is a guy that's been semi-quiet the last couple of games. I mean, he's a guy that could break out, give you big shots. They get to Dragovic, but did not get to Shipp.
Again, they leave Gant. They'll let him take that shot. And I'm sure they'll let him take it until he makes one. Aboya with the rebound. Bruins have done exactly what we suggested they needed to do, and that is take the crowd out of the game early. Shipp drives baseline, cut off by Brockman. Dragovic up top. They'll jump out and guard him. 6 of 7 beyond the arc against Washington State. And they're going to get Dentman on a grab on Collison. Dan, let's take a moment to look at the do's and don'ts, what has to happen, what doesn't have to happen in this game.
All right, Barry, first of all, we're going to take a look at what the Bruins have to do. They got to knock Brockman around a little bit. Don't let him get off. And the other thing, I think it's a three-point advantage for the crowd here. Keep the crowd out of it for UCLA. Control the tempo. Be the chairman of the boards if you're Washington. And the other thing for the Huskies, they cannot allow Collison to get to the free throw line. He leads the country in free throw shooting. Keep him off the line.
So far doing a great job working on a shutout.
Got that high screen and roll, and you better show yourself when coming. That was well done. Good job by Brockman. They may get a foul, though. Another foul on Dentman.
That's two quick ones on Dentman.
Yeah, Overton's going to come in quickly for Dentman. See, I think it's good defensively to show yourself here and eliminate, to impede that dribble, but then when he comes back, got to do a better job of getting around that screen. Boy.
This is Drew Holiday working on Overton to the basket.
Boy, Drew Holiday. Was that a sensational little left-handed move to the goal?
Awesome. Huskies will keep possession. Huskies almost 3 minutes into this game, 0 for 4.
Yeah, UCLA defending them. But how about Drew Holiday? Don't forget, Barry, a right-hander going left. You know, one of the more heralded players. You know, he's the Gatorade High School Basketball Player of the Year last year. So Drew Holiday, you know, right at the top of all the recruiting lists. And what a nice young man, a quality guy, great family. His brother Justin, of course, plays here at Washington. Just a terrific move to take it to the basket.
A lot of trouble getting that in, but Holiday reached in on Brockman. First foul on Giroux. Yeah, the Holiday family on hand.
Oh, there's
mom. That's Toya. Now, Toya's sitting in the UCLA section. And Sean, the dad, well, he's over in the Washington section. There he is right there. They were at both practices yesterday. Delightful family. Really enjoyed our conversation with them. And first time that the Holiday brothers have ever actually hooked up against each other. Thomas for three, had a good look, couldn't get it to go, and the rebound gonna be off of Holiday, and it'll be Washington ball.
Except in the backyard.
In the backyard, they had many encounters, they said. And there is a look at Justin Holiday. We'll see him in a little while.
Yeah, he did a great job coming in on Thursday night against the Trojans. I thought he gave big, big energy when he entered the game.
Over to the scoop, spotted away. And the follow up and missed by Gamp, but he'll go to the line. That was Gooden who knocked that ball away. Gooden is a natural shot blocker.
Well, here's the drive and the penetration, and a good job by Gordon to come over and deflect that ball. So a nice effort. And another young guy, a freshman who can block shots. He's very active, comes in the game early, but he's also an energizer, and he's going to go for every shot. I mean, he'll definitely deflect some shots when it goes all the way to the goal.
Yeah, Drew Gordon, as we said, a natural shot blocker. And he tries to block too many shots sometimes, but he's a freshman.
Well, Lorenzo Wilmar saying at least we're on the board.
Yeah. No field goals yet. But. One out of two for Gant. Holiday with the rebound. Significant, I think, for the Huskies that Dentman is going to have to sit for a while.
A good man-to-man, intense pressure by the Huskies, trying to keep the ball in front.
Holiday, they leave him. And halfway down, came out. Brockman with the rebound. Outlet to Thomas. Thomas leaves for Overton. UCLA doing a great job defensively.
Well, they are. And you know they're going to get off of Gant a little bit. I'm surprised Dragovic is all the way out defending him. I think Brockman's the key guy, Barry. They're going to have to find a way to get it into Brockman. He's being guarded by a freshman in Gordon and see if he can do a little bit of damage on the interior.
Overton tried to split the two defenders and somehow got away with it. Couldn't get the shot up, though, and here's Gordon ahead of everybody for the basket. Gant fouls him hard.
Gant did one thing correctly trailing the play, a nice move by Gordon. I thought he did go for the ball. He didn't just grab him. He made an effort here. And again, you talk about the defense of UCLA. I mean, that's what's winning the game for him early. And, you know, Gordon's thinking block. But a nice job by Gant to go for the orange as he's taking it all the way to the rim.
Huskies still without a basket in this game. They trail 7-1. Gordon misses the first. Matthew Bryan Amening will come into the Huskies lineup, and Gant will sit. Now Amening gives him a little bit more on the offensive end. Gordon misses them both, but Holiday gives him another chance. Collison misses a three, and a rebound still loose. Overton finally picks it up. Bodies everywhere. You can see the Bruins will come out and defend way beyond the three-point line. This is Bryan Amening, lost the handle right in the hands of Collison. It's a race. Not to beat Collison. But he missed the shot.
No. Should be a goaltend.
That's correct.
No, that's a good
call.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. They touched the ball on the square. Excellent call by the outside official.
So 15:32 left here in the first half, and the Huskies don't have a bucket. Nine to one ball game, UCLA over the Huskies. Huskies still looking for their first basket, and there's good reason for it.
Well, Barry, look at the defensive position by UCLA. Look how they're defending every guy. They have great vision on the ball, and it's really paying off for them. They're jumping screens. Look at guys are active. Gordon, a great job to deflect it, then get back in the action. Everybody back in. A good job by Dragovic. And that's why UCLA's got this lead, as Gordon couldn't finalize. He did get fouled. So Ben Howland's got to love the way his team has come out on the road and is defending a very good Washington team.
And he's a guy who preaches defense first. That's what they worked on in practice, a good portion of practice yesterday.
Boy, you love that graphic, 0 for 6. And again, I mean, Gordon is like all over the place.
Double dribble this time.
I know it's a good call on him. May have carried it, but Gordon is like super active defensively.
Yeah, he overplayed that pass.
And Barry, remember, UCLA on the road in the Pac-10 Conference, undefeated. They're 4-0 on the road, so that's huge. The Huskies are 3-0 on the road.
Yeah, that's right.
They lost a triple overtime game here to California. They only lost at home.
One of the few entries they've allowed to Brockman, and Brockman makes a finish.
See, I think that's exactly where they have to go. Being guarded by Gordon, he's a younger guy. You've got to find Brockman at the low block.
Oh, great defense.
Saved by Pondex.
Oh,
Overton, great play.
How do you like
it? Boy, there's a lot of good defense being played in this game. Overton penetrates. Knocked out of bounds off the hands of Dragovic.
One thing I will say, Barry, the officials are letting them play.
Yeah.
Now look at this low post pass, and he's being guarded by a young player, and then Brockman, you know, that's just an excellent move to use the body to go ahead and move. Now, if you're Gordon, you've got to do a better job of getting into Brockman and forcing him a little further away from the goal. They're going to go right back to him again. See, now that's a little further out. That's a better job right there by Drew Gordon.
Drives baseline to the basket.
Except you got to take that baseline away. Got to force him to the middle. Mama Brockman.
Well, you know, Ben Holland was telling his players, he mentioned this in the opening, he was telling his players at practice, this is the toughest guy you're going to play this year. And he's showing you why. And another turnover. 3-on-3, Overton all the way.
Quick timeout.
Now, Ben Holland, the guy who will use his timeouts when he feels they are necessary. He will not save them.
Well, I think the answer for Washington has been, let's go to Brockman. Gordon's got to take away. He's got to force him back to the middle of the floor. And then Brockman saw the opening, and he's finished twice. And then Vannoy Overton. I thought Collison might try to draw the charge, but Overton, a good little ball fake. And the Huskies have three terrific guards. I mean, Detman goes out with two fouls, but they don't drop much when Vannoy Overton comes in the game. And don't forget, John Brockman, no field goals on Thursday night. I thought the Trojans did a marvelous job on him. You knew he was hungry. He said, I can't have that happen again.
Well, remember last year when the UCLA Bruins came into this building, they left a 10-point loser. And that's going on. In fact, the last four games that these teams have played up here, Washington has won the basketball game. They're a good home team. And one of the, you mentioned the crowd, worth probably more than a basket to them.
I think the crowd here is at least worth 3 to 4 points.
Now they got a Boya back in the ball game, and they're going to get Brockman on a hand check. Michael Roll also in the lineup for UCLA for the first time now. And so too is James Keefe. Oh. This time they'll get Keefe over the top.
Now Keefe has been very, very productive of late for UCLA. The last three games, 6 of 8 from the field. He's a good rebounder, solid defender. And you don't drop much when Keefe's in the game.
They've been dropping outside, right about a smaller Huck, rather Boya on him.
They got Brockman.
Yeah, they had him.
They couldn't find him. Well defended.
Drop it down to Brian Allen. With a little turnaround, can't go. Pondexter misses. And Keefe with a rebound. Pondexter had a pretty good look at the rebound, but couldn't quite get it down.
Boy, they're just going to trap Collison every time he gets it.
And Aboya knocks it down. I was going to say that's a shot that I would think the Huskies would let Aboya take. Well, they let him take it. He made it. Overton burns it back. Gives the Pondexter easy off the window.
I think Vannoy Overton may have turned an ankle because he's limping coming back down the floor. That's a little too quick. I think although Roll's a terrific shooter. And UCLA don't want to get into a track meet, but the fact is that if you're going to let anybody shoot that shot, it's Wolf.
Pondexter going to come out of the ballgame, and for the first time, Justin Holliday will come in. And his brother actually will leave for UCLA, and there you can see him roll that left ankle. But he's going to stay out there.
Got to watch the lob to roll on the out of bounds. They've got a size advantage. They like to lob it inside.
Well, they left Chip. And Chip makes him pay. Pure shooter.
Good job on the out of bounds. Last time, remember, Barry, they lobbed it inside. And this time they made the adjustment and went to the perimeter player for the three.
Brian Amenik down low, turnaround, won't go. Keeps the rebound. Now this is Anderson in the ball game for UCLA as well. From the corner, Ship again, look out. That's three threes for him.
I tell you, better close on him.
I'll say.
Ship's got it going.
Back to an 8-point UCLA lead. Thomas working on the freshman Anderson. Freshman on freshman. Thomas with the left hand. How do you like that?
Oh, you've talked a lot about Isaiah Thomas. And Isaiah, a freshman here, a guy that had 51 points in a championship game in high school against Franklin. And he's someone that has allowed the game to flow to him. But now I think he feels with Detman out of the game, he's got to make a play, Barry. And he made a left-hander, very quick and active, and, you know, arguably the most productive freshman in the Pac-10 conference.
Yeah, we're seeing two of the three great freshmen in the Pac-10 in this game. And Thomas is going to come out. Thomas, of course, and Jrue Holiday for the Bruins. DeMar DeRozan for USC. Going to be a tough call to pick the freshman of the year this year.
I think if you're Ben Holland, you're going to take a look at Ship again, try to run some screens for him, and he wants the ball.
Ship again with a good look, not this time. Overton the rebound. And the Huskies push it. Overton on the wing this time. Now Gant. That's Holiday. And go. Fight for the rebound. The long rebound comes out to Ship. And Ship lost the handle, and that's going to be a travel.
No, they say no.
I thought I saw one of the officials call it.
No, I think Ship put the ball on the ground but did a good job to recover. You know what I love about it? Officials are letting them go. They're letting them play here, which is great.
And another turnover as Overton gets on the floor again. And we'll take a timeout. 11:17 left. Up and down game. 17-12. Bruins. So for the Bruins now, it's Anderson, Gordon, Roll, Keith, and Ship. And for the Huskies, Overton, Elston Turner, Gant, Justin Holiday, and Brian Amening. That's Brian Amening. Underneath, couldn't get it traveled. Substitutions now for the Bruins as into the ball game once again comes Nikola Dragovic, and he brings Collison with him, and also in the game for the first time, Malcolm Lee, another talented freshman who really hasn't been available to Ben Holland very much. He's been nursing an injury much of the year.
I think the one thing you're seeing with UCLA, Ben Holland, he's substituting a lot more in this game. In the loss to Arizona State, Collison played 42 minutes. A lot of the guys after that game said they wouldn't admit it on the floor, but they were tired. And after really a tough game on Thursday night, Ben Holland using his bench. That may be a travel also.
That is on Malcolm Lee. Sixth UCLA turnover. It's turnovers really are keeping the Huskies in the fray here.
Yeah, because they're getting out rebounded. And don't forget, Washington leads the nation in rebound differential at over 11 a game.
Right now, John Brockman not in the ball game. UCLA has already used 10 players, and the Huskies, in fact, have used 9. Liberal substituting for both coaches. Gant down low.
Thought a great pass by Holiday.
Barry Tompkins, Dan Bowamini alongside. We're at the Bank of America Arena here in Seattle. It's a battle for first place in the Pac-10 Conference between the hometown Washington Huskies and the UCLA Bruins. And it's been an intense kind of ball game so far. This is Gordon working on Brian Amening. Little jump hook.
Well, Gordon's made an impact in this game. Defensively, and a nice little move inside. And so is Overton. Good to see that he's back. I thought he may have tweaked an ankle earlier in the game. And, of course, Overton's going to play major minutes with Detman picking up two fouls.
Two quick fouls. So Detman's been on the bench probably for about 7 minutes already. Gordon again down low working on Brian Amany. Not this time. Come up short. And Gant tried to save. Couldn't. It'll be UCLA ball.
This is a nice little runner in the lane. And again, a left-hander shooting it right-handed. A good move here. Got to get on Ship. And a good move by Holiday to negate Ship from getting that inbound pass. Ship's made three threes in the game.
Now come up.
Oh, look at that back door.
Malcolm Lee. Now Collison had an open look for three, but instead floats it up off the window. It won't go, and the follow is no good by Lee. Great pass that time for Overton to Brian Amening, but the return to Overton just dribbles off his hands and out of bounds. And now Lo Romar is going to get John Brockman back in the ball game.
I'm sure Lorenzo just taking Brian Amity, just slow it. He made a great catch in that transition, but let's take our time and let's get some valued possessions. We can ill afford to turn the ball over like we did Thursday night against the Trojans.
So here's, again, two more freshmen, Lee and Turner, matching up against one another. Post Lee up on Turner, and Lee can't convert. Gant snatches the rebound. There's Elston Turner. He's open. That's a two. Won't go. A little quick. Collison coming the other way. Look out. Four on one.
Slow it down.
And it's Ship. Little pass is a little high for him. Ship down low. And they're going to get a foul.
I think
count the basket.
I think they're going to count. I thought that was a terrific decision by Ship. A, not to travel. B, he makes a great catch. And C, finds a way to score. I think the catch is superb. The foul inside. And look at Ship under control. Boys, he had a big first half for UCLA.
I'll say he's got 11 at the line to try to make it 12. And Overton will leave and Thomas will come back. Dentman, remember, two early fouls, has been on the bench since about the 3 minute mark.
Now I asked Josh Ship, who's a better long-range shooter, you, Joe, or Jaron? His brother Joe, of course, was a great, great player in California. He says, me, I still think it's Joe.
And then Jaron said,
well, I'm a pretty good long-range shooter. Jaron's at Arizona State.
There's that great entry pass again from Holiday to Brockman. Brockman with the finish and one. He is a load.
No, he's a difference maker, certainly inside. And this afternoon, he's getting great looks. They're playing right behind him. Now, I think you may have to adjust that if you're UCLA. But if Brockman backs you down, Barry, and he gets the ball 3 feet from the basket, and you don't double him, forget it. I mean, Brockman's going to either score or he's going to get fouled.
At the line, converts the old-fashioned three-point play. Back to a three-point ball game. Brockman with seven. Bobo Morgan in the ball game for UCLA, so he's the 11th player. Does give you some bulk, bumps off Brockman and puts it in.
Yeah, I thought a very positive move. I think Lorenzo Romar wanted to travel. Looked like to me he may have shuffled a little bit, but Jamison Morgan, how about that? A productive score right away coming in.
Pondexter drew a crowd, scored the basket. Tell you what, this is a high tempo, intense basketball game. And a foul away from the ball called on Thomas. So we'll jump away. UCLA leads it 24-21. We're going to talk about that guy on Dan's Old School when we come back. Bruins lead it by three. They've led right from the start. Well, it gives us an opportunity right now to introduce Dan's jacket. And we're talking old school about Bob Hooks Hubregs. And he played back in 1952, 1953, a big time offensive player.
Yeah, he really did play for Tippy Dye back in those days. And, you know, he is still the second leading all-time scorer in Washington history, Barry.
And still a great fan. And right now he is with Carissa Thompson. Carissa.
Hello, Bob. It only took him 56 years to find another guy as good as you, huh? To get his jersey retired. Brandon Roy, of course, having his jersey, only the second Washington Husky to have his jersey retired next to yours. Quite an honor for both of you, huh?
Well, especially for Brandon. He's not only a great player, he's a better person. And I'm really proud to have my number up there with his.
And this game, how about this game? This is fantastic. Your kind of game, Bob.
That fantastic game. I tell you, UCLA is tough.
All right.
Tough.
Well,
thank you.
You heard it from Bob first, and he knows a thing or two about basketball, guys.
He sure does. He had, in one season, 1953, he had, what was it, 49,
45,
45, 42,
and 35.
All in one game. In 1953,
yeah.
That's a lot of points.
And
Connison.
His nickname, Barry, Bob Hubricks.
Hooks.
I thought keeping the crowd out of it was pivotal for UCLA, and so far they've done a very good job.
Justin Dettman is back in the ballgame, playing with two fouls, so he has to be somewhat careful. It's going to be a foul before the shot. Will be a shooting situation, however. So Lorenzo Romar rolling the dice a little bit here with Justin Dettman.
And I think the reason he puts Dettman back in the game, Barry, I think he wants to go back to his normal guard combination. He doesn't want to play one guard and four bigs. Instead, he wants to get that rotation, put a little more pressure on, get the smaller guys in the game. But you're right. You know, when you're in jeopardy with the two fouls, like Dettman, you don't want to pick up that third foul in the first half.
Dettman spent more than 11 minutes on the bench, and Pondexter gets both free throws. Also significant, remember, Washington came into this weekend, starting with Thursday night, ninth in the conference in free throw shooting. They shot it at 82% on Thursday night, and so far today, 5 of 6.
Yeah, they did a great job. They were 32 of 40 on Thursday night, and that one there, Morgan, a little bit awkward, couldn't get that one in, and Washington with an open court opportunity.
Well, that's a shot that will get you back on the bench. Pondexter hammered. No, jump ball, and the possession arrow will be the Huskies. Got all ball, they say.
Here on the transition, watch Brockman read the defense. Now they're doubling him, and he does a good job. Looked like there was a lot of leather right there.
I think that was a good call.
Yeah, he did a nice job to find the open guy. Look at Brockman inside against Keith.
Pondexter brings it back out. Now Dettman up top.
Well, they're trying to go to Brockman 40 on the other side of the floor if they could just rotate it over there.
Dettman just double clutches all the way to the basket and draws a foul.
That's why they got to have Dettman in the game.
Well, you know, Justin Dettman was a pure one for the first 3 years he was here at Washington. And all of a sudden, when Isaiah Thomas came, they said, I'll tell you what, you go over, you play the two, just worry about shooting the basketball, which he hadn't done very well in the last couple of years. He did that. He's turned into a different player. Look at his numbers from Thursday.
Look at those free throw numbers, too. He was 11 out of 11, and he made some big, big threes in the clutch.
Nikola Dragovic comes back into the UCLA lineup, and Keith will sit. So the Huskies staying in the game at the free throw line, and that's not something I would have thought we would be saying on Saturday. Dettman gets them both. 7 of 8. And a one-point ball game.
Now, you know, Collison is aware that the man guarding him has a couple of fouls. There's a great over the top.
Sure,
just couldn't get it in, and a nice little follow.
Well, that's Gordon again. Gordon very active.
Gordon's above the rim.
Well, Brockman's there for the entry pass. But a good job by Dragovic to prevent it, and Dettman just pulls up and sticks it.
Now, see if Collison utilizes the dribble, tries to get something going to the goal to pick up the third foul on Dettman. You know, Collison is really smart and he understands the game. And he may, if they give him a little clear out, run a two-man game, put it on the floor.
Just what he did, kicks out for Ship, and they jump out at him. So Ship puts it on the floor, did everything to finish. Devin, 1-on-4, I think he'll wait. Thomas for 3. Would have given the Huskies their first lead of the ball game. And Pondexter steps in front, goes hard into Chris Roberts, actually, the UCLA radio announcer. There's Chris, and a nice assist by Chris.
Yeah, good assist. The only one he's ever had.
That's right. And didn't miss a word.
No, he did not miss a beat. Still talking.
Look at this. Pondexter are going to come out of the game, and Justin Holliday will come back for Washington. Just under 5 minutes remaining here in the first half. An intense game. You can see the Bruins still with a rebounding edge. Vladovic, 6 of 7 the other night, not today.
Well, it's all because of Gordon, I think. I mean, you see that rebound advantage. A big, big factor has been Drew Gordon. And he may have stepped on the end line. He made it really a superb effort to get that ball off the iron, but could not retain his balance, and out of bounds, it will go to the Huskies.
So once again, the Huskies with an opportunity to take their first lead of the afternoon.
And let's see if they go right here to Brockman. See if they can find John Brockman down around the goal. Now they're going to bring him a little further out.
And he traveled.
Yeah, he took that little step.
So James Keefe going to come back. Dragovic will leave. Both coaches shuffling a lot of bodies in and out of the game. Now, Lo Romar will answer with Gint, and Brockman will sit.
I think both coaches kind of gearing up for the second half.
Yeah,
they know they're going to need their primetime guys in there. So let's substitute freely in the first half. As long as you're close, you can afford to do it.
Here's Holliday. He's got a size advantage on Isaiah Thomas. Collison shook one man, now pulls up for the 3. Comes up short, tight for the rebound.
Again.
Gordon again. And a great reach in that time by Brian Amening, and on the tied up ball. The possession arrow will be UCLA's, but a nice job by Brian Amening.
And remember the last time they took the ball out of bounds in this situation, they lobbed the ball inside to Holliday, number 21. And Holliday's right around the goal again. Michael Roll's a guy that come off the screen. So you see Holliday right here. See, he's got a size advantage. This time they go different. They go right to Collison and give it back to him. They miss the shot. UCLA's got a variety of out-of-bounds plays with the same set.
They spend a lot of time working on those, too. Detman in the corner. Now he's got a bigger man on him. This map someplace, trying to find it. Kickback this time. Thomas steps in. All the way. How do you like that? I don't think Thomas thought it was going to be that easy.
I think shooting it may have been an afterthought.
Yeah.
Look, he's smiling. Said, well, I couldn't realize. I didn't realize I could do that.
He looked up, and suddenly there was nobody there. One-point game, Bruins. Well, there's no question who the boss is amongst the Washington Huskies. That's Lorenzo Romar, and even the mighty get humbled sometime, eh, Carissa?
That's right. I just saw Coach Romar get up in John Brockman's face after John committed that traveling call, and he says, you cannot travel. And he stomped his foot, kind of stressing the fundamentals in a game like this. You cannot commit those errors. But, of course, he gets in John's face because he is the best. John was awarded the PI Sports Star of the Year Award earlier this week, and I had talked to John about the award. I mean, of course, John's been the recipient of many awards, and he said this one was special. He goes, I just thought I was going to get a good dinner. I was literally shocked when they called my name.
Well, I tell you what, he's a high-character guy. And, you know, you heard Hooks Hubriggs talking about Brandon Roy, what a good human being he is, and you can say the exact same thing about this guy right here.
Yeah, you really can. And Carissa, I want to tell Carissa one thing. Maybe she could tell Coach Romar overlook it a little bit with Brockman and get him back in the game, which he did.
I'll make sure to relay that message.
Carissa, make sure you kind of tell him that at halftime. Don't take him out too often.
You got it, guys.
Collison going to back it out. Now he tries to drive on Dettman. Remember, Dettman is playing with the two fouls. He got right up on Collison when he picked the dribble up that time.
All right, great defensive set here for Washington. Well, shot clock down. Now you're in trouble.
Nope, they didn't get it off. It sure was a great defensive set.
Yeah, it really was coming out of that timeout. And Ben Holland said, that's fine. This is hang in there. And then Collison, a desperation shot. But really, it was intense man-to-man ball in front of you. Good position by the Huskies.
And there's Pondexter up the elbow now. Oh. Drop it down to Brockman. Great delivery by Pondexter. And great job defensively by UCLA, but a foul.
Now, if it's Keith, Barry, it may be his third, if it is Keith.
It is. And it is his third.
And Aboya has two. Keith has three.
So I don't think there's any question where the Huskies are going to go. And Brockman, all of a sudden, is lights out at the free throw line.
And Brockman has not been lights out for the year. He's like a 53-54% free throw shooter, and he was in a slump prior to this weekend. You know, a big one, shooting way under 50% from the line, but shot his free throws well in the last couple of games.
Gets both of these and gives his team the lead for the first time in the ball game. With 3 minutes and 4 seconds remaining, Huskies on an 8-2 run over the last 3 minutes and 50 seconds. Both teams are really stepping up defensively.
Yeah, Pondexter has taken the challenge on Ship. Look what he's doing with Ship. They're all over him. Good recognition. Got to go straight up.
Well, going to get a reach in. Was very close.
Magnificent pass, I thought, by Josh Ship. Look at the double. He brings it down. You got to go straight up on that one. You've got it in there. Take it strong to the goal. The more you gather, the more you're in trouble. And it's been an adventure here for Gordon from the foul line also. I mean, he's a sub 50% free throw shooter.
Missed two earlier. Overton incidentally picked up his second foul. And Gordon does get that one. And Isaiah Thomas is going to come back in the lineup. Dettman will sit. So Dettman did not get himself in any further trouble. About this Washington team, you saw us smiling and kind of jiving on the sidelines. And one on two for Gordon. Brockman the rebound. They all get along together. They all hang out together, and that's just one of those things. There's no rhyme or reason to it. Some teams have it, some teams don't. And I can tell you, the Huskies do.
Well, so does UCLA.
Yes.
Okay, what a guard matchup. I mean, there's like pressure on pressure in this game.
But Overton with the control of the body and puts it in with the right hand and will go to the free throw line. A big time play.
Cannot overemphasize, Barry, the depth in the backcourt for the Huskies. They've got three outstanding players, and Benoy Overton, he's a heck of a player in his own right, comes off the bench, but automatically when he's in the game, he gives Washington a real lift.
And he will go to the free throw line. Now they have three outstanding guards. And you got to give it up to Congress, too, and you've made mention of this. He has been guarding Ship for the last several minutes, and he has kept Ship pretty quiet.
And one thing I will say about Quincy Pondexter, in previous years, he'd be forcing it a little bit if he didn't score right away. Now he's matured. He's dedicating himself on defense and letting the game flow to him.
That was a great move without the ball by Holiday. Count the basket and one. That's one of the bottom lines. You always talk about that, Coach, moving without the basketball.
Yeah, and recognition when you do have the ball.
He does. Tied at 31. We talked about the Holiday brothers never having played against each other, and even though they're on opposite teams here, they've not been on the floor at the same time tonight either. A leaner by Thomas. Count it.
Well, you think you're doing the right thing by forcing him to go right. He's a lefty, and you know UCLA sitting on that left hand. But this is a multi-dimensional, talented young guy. And look at this powerful move to the goal. A little bit of Nate the Great Robinson and Isaiah Thomas. Remember, Nate here doing a nice job. Remember, 5'8", strong, can take it to the basket. And fouls on Gordon. It's his third. So Gordon with three, Keith with three, Aboya with two, and UCLA in jeopardy in the front line in terms of fouls.
And here again, the Huskies the other night went to the free throw line. It was 30 times, I believe.
No, 40.
40.
40.
It was 30, one of those round
numbers.
They were
32 of 40, Barry, from the foul line.
Well, they take him to the basket hard. Now it's Justin Holiday who's guarding Collison. Now Holiday and Holiday are on the floor for the first time. Dragovich!
Well, he has really redefined his body, Nikola Dragovich, with really a guy that was overweight a year ago, but has toned himself down now and playing great basketball and giving UCLA a big lift.
Yeah, Ben Howland told us he fell in love and got fat.
And also he had a double hernia, too. And,
that too.
And I think when he had the double hernia, you know, it took a lot of life out of him and gained a lot of weight. And he's rededicated himself and playing terrific basketball. And he's in great physical shape and has had a big year for UCLA.
I'll say.
You know, coming off a big game. And Pullman made six threes.
Sorry. You don't see too many guys that are as quick as Collison. I'm not too sure, but the Thomas is not just as quick. Got nine on the shot clock. They got to recognize here. Thomas recognizes. Almost had it. Looked pretty good when he left his hand. And a loose ball, and let's see. Still no call.
You know, everybody doing the right thing. Though. When the ball's on the ground, let's just dive after it, roll over, and let the official make the call, and it may go to UCLA.
And it does go to UCLA. Yeah, it has been a tough, physical game. That's the right call.
Remember, when you're playing against the Huskies, they are one of the leading rebounding teams in the country. So you've got to hold your own. We thought a big key for Washington was to be chairman of the boards, control the glass, and they have
Morgan
pass. Oh, that was a tremendous pass by Holiday.
Morgan with the finish. So Morgan with a couple of baskets, giving Ben Holland some help off the bench. Pondexter can't get it. And it's going to be out of bounds to Washington. Right now, UCLA outboarding the Huskies by three. And a 30-second timeout going to be called by Lorenzo Romar. 37-35 ball game. I mean, it's been a game that's been exactly as advertised.
Yeah, it really has. And UCLA now in a 5-0 run. And I think Lorenzo Romar wanted to burn a 30. Barry, watch the play here. Stop it here. Look at this. Look at the pass inside. And beautifully done by Holiday to give it to Morgan for the finish. And I thought a great play by Morgan to catch, not travel, and the peripheral vision by Drew Holiday. Outstanding. Morgan's giving him a lift.
Yeah,
he's come
no
in the
question.
Game and got a couple of field goals.
So once again, you know, the Bruins just giving up the ball really well. Both these teams, very unselfish teams, always trying to get the ball to the open guy. There was a play with Jrue Holiday moving without the basketball.
Yeah, remember this one here on the dribble, and watch the back cut, and watch that beautiful pass on the back cut. And this was Dragovich. Look at the back cut. Beautifully done to take it all the way to the goal and score. That, again, is massive recognition by UCLA, how the defense is playing.
About a 5-second differential between game clock and shot clock.
Good steal. Holiday, see if he gives it up, of course.
To Collison for the finish.
You know, this guy, Holiday, he's effortless. I mean, he is a smooth, smooth player. God, I love his game.
Very talented freshman. Arguably the number one high school player in the country last year. They leave Thomas. Now he drops down the corner for Ponder, or rather for Holiday, for wide open tray. My brother can do it. I can do it too.
Bet. Hey, bro, if you can make one, I can do it. And from deep, how do you like it?
What a first half of basketball here. Exactly as we expected. Two good teams playing excellent basketball, particularly on the defensive end. Thomas, I thought, passed up a shot for a wide open Holiday, and he drained it. to end the first half. So at the break, the UCLA Bruins 39 and the Washington Huskies 38 in a game that has been a tremendous game right from the get-go. Welcome back, Barry Tompkins, Dan Bowamany alongside. 1-point ball game at the half, UCLA over the hometown Washington Huskies. A well-played game. Let's take a look, Dan, at some of the numbers. UCLA shooting it at 50%. The Huskies not quite as good. Each team with 7 turnovers, and the rebounds, of course, are a story.
Yeah, big story there, and UCLA controlled the boards, and Washington controlled it inside. So that's a big play. Look at points in the paint for the Huskies, 22. So it's been a well-played first half.
It really was, and I don't expect any different in the second half, and it's a game that is going to be there for either team. We're coming back. We welcome you back. We start the second half with UCLA, a 1-point leader over the Washington Huskies, a 39-38 ball game. Here is our take it away game summary, and both teams took it away on 7 occasions, but really it was only the Washington Huskies that converted off those turnovers. Most of the turnovers, incidentally, it must be said, have been forced. So take it in theaters Friday. Huskies with the first possession of the second half. Made a big three at the end of the first half to make it a 1-point ball game.
They try to go right over the top to Brockman immediately.
And I think they make it a boy right out of the box here. We'll see. I think it's going to go with Shipp, who is guilty of the foul. Well, let's go down right now while we have a moment to Carissa Thompson. Carissa.
Yeah, speaking of Josh Shipp, I caught up with Coach Romar at halftime, and I had remarked on the fact that they had doubled up on him. He said, yeah, he got away early on us. As far as John Brockman and the success that he had, we were talking about the fact that Washington, as you guys all know, got off to that slow start. He said, yeah, he wasn't establishing himself on that low post like he did later on. Once the Huskies got him the ball, then the game just took off, and it was a completely different game. So always look for John Brockman first and foremost.
All right, thanks, Carissa. It's a new game right now, 39 all. So we basically start from scratch.
Well, as Carissa said, Barry, the whole game revolves around Brockman for the Huskies. They've got to continually look for him as much as they can when they come down the floor. Ooh, good defense there and a good call. Looked like it was definitely off Thomas.
Thomas, though, quick hands. Knocked it out of Drew Holiday's hands. Now Collison matched up with Detman. That's been a good matchup all day, too.
Yeah, high screen and roll. And don't forget Collison. He will get proactive when the Bruins really need him to. He doesn't force it, but came on late in the game against Washington State to make some big scores.
Yeah, he only had one field goal for the first, 37 minutes of that game. A little bit of a carry there, I thought, but shot no good. Yeah, I was waiting for somebody to tackle him.
But back him down. But they had Brockman in, throw it in there.
Thomas tries to penetrate. Thomas in the way, certainly. The foul. Thomas, a very good penetrator, but he can step out and shoot it. Now, he hasn't done that very much today.
Well, what impressed me about Isaiah Thomas, we know he's super quick. He can make the outside shot, but he's strong. I mean, he's a guy that can go around the rim. He can post you up. He can find a way to get to the foul line.
Well, you know, we were talking to him about what his biggest moment was, and he said it didn't happen in a game. He said he played one-on-one with Jamal Crawford and beat him.
Yeah, of course, Jamal Crawford with the Golden State Warriors. Yeah. Now, of course, Jamal went to Michigan. And beat Jamal.
Okay. That's pretty good.
Well, I would say if they played, though, five times, he certainly would not win five.
No. No. Jamal can shoot it a little bit.
I mean, I think Crawford has had a couple of, like, you know, 40-plus games in the NBA.
Bring a boy away, out away from the basket. Holiday pulls the trigger and scores from three-point range. And there's Toya Holiday, his mom. A legend that Sean, the dad, is sitting on the Washington side. Toya, the mom, sitting on the UCLA side. Devin got in the lane. Follow-up this is by Pondexter. Another follow by Pondexter. Pondexter gets it back a third time.
I mean, talk about relentless on the glass. Well, that's why they lead the nation in a rebound differential. Great job by Quincy Pondexter.
Also, Pondexter's really come on since about the midway point of the first half.
He's prime time, and there, get a little foul on him. A good call on Ship.
He didn't agree with it. He thought Ship might have been flailing his elbows a little bit. Look at this. There's one.
There's two.
There's three.
And there's four.
Come back, get it, finish. That's impressive.
Look like his dad or his uncle. You know, Roscoe, of course, a magnificent rebound. Clifton, his uncle, went when he played at Long Beach, the great Long Beach team back in the early 70s for Lute Olson. I mean, Clifton played so high on the square, it was unbelievable. There's Roscoe. And Roscoe still looks like he can play.
Yeah, he does.
I mean, he's right into it.
The other way, Thomas puts it on the floor, drives on Collison, draws the foul on Collison.
Turn to the foul number two, Derek Collison of the Bruins. First personal foul, three T-fouls on UCLA.
Now, you know, coming out of the out of bounds, they will try to feature Brockman if they can get him. Just turn and see if they can find him in there. He was there. Now they find him.
Oh! Draws the foul again. Now let's see who they get.
Now they can either get Holiday, who was close, or Aboye. If it's Aboye, it's going to be his third.
Aboye.
Aboye really got cut. Oh, Aboye.
That's a headbutt. So we go to the scorer's cards after the fifth round. That's a little boxing joke.
Right? Yeah, no, I've seen a match or two. And this was, I mean, this game is physical here. And Aboye got hit hard.
Did he?
And he's saying, wait, the foul's on me? I mean, I don't quite understand that. Yeah, now you get a great look at it. Yeah, I think if you're Ben Howland and the Bruins, you may have a little case there.
44-43 ball game. Bruins by one over the Huskies. And Aboye, they are still working on the UCLA bench. Let's take a moment for our Motel 6, sixth man of the game. And it is Michael Roll. And, of course, a great shooter from the perimeter. Seven, almost 8 points a game this year, playing just under 20 minutes. 53% three-point shooter and has been a great shooter all along. Was granted another year of eligibility because of that plantar fasciitis last year. Caused him to miss the entire season. Incidentally, they called that last foul on Jrue Holiday and not on Aboye, so they didn't add insult to injury. And they still